It's about that time of day again. My name is Joseph, Thursday evening, October 25th. Welcome back to your nightly newsletter. My job is to help new traders earn consistent profits using a simple and reliable trading strategy. And my plan this evening is to identify the most reliable trading opportunities setting up for tomorrow's trading session. And tonight, I'm covering crude oil, S&P, Nasdaq, gold, and euro. Starting off this evening, crude oil is bullish with a big spike in range pattern, and that tells me to use those range expansion levels in combination with the two-try failure for buying opportunities back to the highs tomorrow. The S&P is bearish with what will most likely become a spike in channel in the overnight session, and when it does, the plan is pretty simple, looking for selling opportunities with bull traps up above the high of that channel. Nasdaq is also bears the strong spike lower, so I'm staying patient and I got my eyes on selling opportunities on the Nasdaq up at the high of a hidden channel tomorrow. Gold is bullish coming off the low of a range tonight, and my goal is to find buying opportunities using bear traps before we get back to retest the high. And we can't forget about the euro. The euro's bearish as well, but with price testing the outer limits of the range, I'm looking for buying opportunities. Yes, buying opportunities, but I'm waiting for a specific two-try seller failure trap combination tomorrow morning. You're going to definitely want to stick around for that euro chart at the end of tonight's newsletter. We're getting ready to wrap up what has been a crazy week in the markets this week. We've got a Friday session right around the corner. We just finished the afternoon session with some big moves down. We got some ranges. We've got some strong trends. And as always, I've got a reliable plan of attack for Friday morning session. Before we jump into those charts, though, and put the plan together, I need to remind you, if you're here tonight watching me on YouTube, you can find a detailed description of this entire trading strategy written out right here on my blog at sidewaysmarkets.com. I'll leave all the links in the description of this video. Also, if you have any questions about anything covered in this video tonight, please remember you can post them in the comment section below. And if you like what you see, please help support this channel by subscribing and don't forget to hit the bell icon so you always get notified every time I publish something new. And if your goal is to become a consistently profitable trader, you can get your transformation started by joining our mailing list right on the homepage. All I need is your name and your email address, and I'll send you an email to get that transformation going. Don't forget, you can download all the charts from tonight's video. All the charts in tonight's video, you can get them on your computer ready for tomorrow. There's a link right below the video on our blog here at Sideways Markets. And then don't forget, if you have any questions about any of this tonight, you can always pick up the phone and call that toll-free number in the upper right-hand corner. Let's jump right in. A lot to cover here tonight, and I am running a few minutes late. I do apologize for keeping you guys waiting here in a very busy afternoon working with some new clients here today. So great to be here with you all, though. Wrapping up the week tomorrow. Tomorrow, of course, is Friday, October 26th. What do we have on the schedule? We got the GDP number tomorrow. Now, if you remember, we've seen some red-hot GDP numbers over the past three quarters. In fact, the last one, what was it, 4.1, right, compared to just 2 years ago was 3% higher. So we've had some red-hot GDP numbers over the past few months. Tomorrow will be quite interesting because unless you've been living under a rock, this week has been a week where we've seen a lot of down days on the equity markets. A lot of people have turned bearish in their opinion of the market right now. I even heard people whispering the word recession in the news media this afternoon as well. So tomorrow could be a little bit more gasoline on that bearish fire if that GDP number misses tomorrow morning. I can't imagine anything more disastrous than seeing an expectation miss on GDP tomorrow. So we'll be looking closely here tomorrow morning to see how the market reacts to that GDP number. They're expecting a big number tomorrow, but watch out for that surprise number that comes in under the radar, because combine that with the bloodbath we've seen so far this week, it could really turn sour that overall sentiment, and that could really send these markets tumbling lower tomorrow morning. Don't forget, we're going to be in our trade room at 8 o'clock Eastern time. We will have a front row seat for that GDP number, and I would love to see you there with me as a brand new member here at School of Trade. Let's jump into our charts here tonight. I want to make sure I don't take up too much of your valuable time. I know I'm getting to it late here tonight. So we got crude oil, we got some S&P, we'll do the Nasdaq, and of course the gold and the euro. Starting off tonight on oil, crude is bullish with a spike in range spike and channel, a triangle and a measured move on the chart this evening. And the bulls have the momentum. You can see how that most recent move higher, right, is bullish. So the plan is to buy support levels with the proper entry patterns tomorrow morning. Looking at support, the most important clues are this spike and channel. Spike and channels tell me to go back and look at the deepest part of that channel and look to buy off the base of the channel. The spike into the range, which I think is the most important clue. We take that trading range, we copy and paste up to find resistance, copy and paste down to find support, right? So we got some great support levels here from that spike and range at 82, from that spike and channel at 66. So those are the big clues right now. And no matter what happens with that market bullish going higher, whether you want to call it a range or you want to call it a channel, the most important thing is once we make that move lower, we've now got the bears locked in. They're going to try to sell that next pullback, and that will allow us now to use what we call the two-try failure pattern. Wait for those sellers to sell off the moving average, then we know where their stops are, and we can look to buy right into their stops. Now, another thing you want to keep in mind out for tomorrow is this larger triangle. You'll notice how I'm drawing trend lines off those highs. I'm going to draw them off the low. And so in all reality, we could end up back and forth inside this triangle. Now, the one thing you want to keep in mind on that, right, when we do have a wide range like this, is that if we do get the market moving lower, wide range means wide to try. So one try, pull back, two try, and then the buy back up again. So let's quick recap here. The bulls have control. First scenario is going to be this spike and range. Spike and range gives me key support down at 82. It also gives me key resistance up around that 67.80. If I'm trading a spike and range, I'm looking for the two try pattern. One try, pull back, two try. Once I see that second try, I'm looking for that buy going back up into the range. One try, two try, back up into that range. The other pattern is the spike and channel. Spike and channel patterns we talk about a lot on this newsletter. They tell me to focus on that deepest part of that channel. Same pattern. One try, two try, failure back up. So the spike and channel and the spike and range basically tell me the exact same thing. Get price moving lower, get those sellers to try to sell once, sell twice. Once we got them roped in, we can look for that failure and buy it back up. The big challenge I see tomorrow is if we see the market tumble, which could easily happen because, again, we have right that big triangle. If we do see the market tumble lower, what will likely happen is you'll see a wide to try. You'll see a strong move down, a move back up, another move lower. That will give me that one try, two try. And then we'll start looking for those failures into hidden channel pullback patterns. Find that new channel. Failure into hidden channel pullbacks now going back up into that range. So again, the most important thing if we do end up going lower here is don't get too aggressive trying to buy it back up, because that momentum will be very strong as it goes lower. You want to let this thing pull back, try again. Once you get that, again, my trick is anytime the range is wide, I look for a wide to try. So one try, let it go up. Two try, come down. I'm not looking for it like this. That's not the trade we're looking for. I would do that here. One try, two try, go. One try, two try, go. I'll do it here. One try, two try, go. But the problem is when the momentum gets going too far, that momentum turns bearish, you're not going to want to try to buy that one. You're going to want to wait for that one and then wait for that next leg down. And you'll see it. It'll come out of nowhere. It'll make it feel like we're bearish now, but it will only be the second attempt from those bears. We're at the low of this range. Once we get that second attempt, then we can look for that failure into strength, strength into two-legged, into hidden channel pullback, and we'll look for that move going back up into that range. So far here this afternoon, we're talking about two try rules, one try, two try. We're talking about a wide two try, one, two, and then back up, hidden channel pullback patterns. And I want to give you a much deeper dive into this strategy, show you a lot more about these patterns. But to do that, I've got to keep moving on this newsletter because I'm late and I want to make sure I cover everything tonight. If you want a deeper dive into the entire strategy that we use every day in our trade room, grab that free course in the upper right-hand corner. I'm going to put a link up for a free trading class below the video as well. If you're on the blog and you want to learn more about the two try patterns, the pullback patterns, and everything we use in our trade room, I've got a free trading class for you. It's linked up in the description or in the upper right hand corner. So that's the plan there for the crude tomorrow. Relatively easy on oil. Let's keep going. Now over to the E-minis. There's not a lot on the chart tonight, so we're going to do our best to anticipate what is likely coming next. The S&P is obviously bearish with a strong spike lower, a hidden channel, a possible spike in channel, and a measured move on the chart this evening. The bears have the momentum. It's very, very obvious with these earnings, right, failing and the markets collapsing into the close tonight. And that bear momentum tells me to look for selling opportunities up at levels of resistance levels, right, up at levels of resistance tomorrow morning. So I'm trying to find levels of resistance. I've got a hidden channel I've drawn down. Okay, that's a level of resistance. And I've got these swings, right? Swing here at 88, we'll call it, right? Swing here at 95 3/4. That's about all we've got. All we really know for sure right now is that we have a strong move down, and we have to assume that these sellers are trying to get back down to retest that 52. You know, sometimes you get these moves where we spent most of the day today that was bullish, but now we have this strong move down. You can't even analyze this as a bull. It's got to be looked at right now as a bear. We don't see these situations that often, but it's definitely something that we have to be ready for tomorrow. We have potentially a measured move, right? But let's be very clear here. The goal for the bears is to get back down and retest that 52 1/4. That is the goal right now for those sellers. So how do we proceed from here? Because it's not much on the chart. There's not much to work with, right? This isn't much of a channel. There's just not much to work with here because of that sharp move down. All we really know is direction, and we know objective, right? That 52 1/4. So here are a couple things you want to consider. One would be the hidden channel. I like the hidden channel, but it's very much underdeveloped right now. We don't know if it's actually going to perform tomorrow. For all I know, we may not even be able to use it. But that's going to be a level of resistance that we can use overhead. What I would expect here after this much move lower is one of two scenarios. One is either a range, or two would be a channel, right? A spike in channel down. Usually when you see a market move this far in such a short period of time, this is coming out of earnings, right? It'll usually go range bound. So what's the plan if it goes range bound? If we start seeing the market drift sideways here, right, in the overnight session, we start seeing these double bottoms or a triangle, right? Lower highs and higher lows, right? We start seeing that sideways movement, the moving average flattens out, right? Et cetera, et cetera. Once we see that sideways movement, now we know we have a range. I've got that falling resistance trend line overhead. I want to use that as resistance. I've got these swings overhead. We'll use those as resistance. The bottom line is it's bearish into a range. So two try rule, one try, pull back. Two try. Once we get those buyers trying once and trying twice, and it may not be that pronounced, it might be much smaller here, right? It might be one, two, and then back down. So we don't quite know how far this thing will pull back, but that's the goal, right? Let them go once, let them pull back to the moving average, let them try twice, and then we'll look for that, right? One try, two try, failure, and sell into that low. That's sell back down to that low, and of course leave that runner down to that 52 1/4. Now the other scenario is we had a strong spike down, right? We may use this midline. So I add the midline on. That midline may quickly become the high of a channel. Now, how will you know if it's a spike in channel? If we pull back and make a new lower low on strength. If we make that new lower low, now we'll take out the trend line, draw off of those lows, bring it up to that high, and now you know exactly where you want to be selling. We're selling off the high of that channel. We're finding prior swings, and we're looking for traps into two try failures and back down again. So those are really the two main scenarios I'm getting ready for, and we'll know more as we have more information here tonight. It would also be a good idea to keep an eye on a buyer failure up above that moving average. One try, two try, back down. I mean, that would be ideal. We'll see if we get it. This big, strong move at the end of today's session, though, we may, again, like I said, I would expect go sideways or a channel here, but maybe we do pull back. The problem is we're too bearish to buy this thing, right? So what we'll do is we'll wait for it to try once. We'll wait for it to try again. Then we know where the stops are, and we can look to sell into those stops. In fact, most of the time, these types of patterns will end up turning into a two-try failure into what we call a hidden channel pullback pattern. We're then waiting for that new channel and selling off that high. So you're selling that two try failure, then you're selling right that pullback off of that channel. We talk about this little combination setup, right? That two try into that hidden channel pattern. So that is definitely on my radar tomorrow if we can get this thing up above the moving average. So really, it's really three scenarios. One scenario is we go up above the moving average quickly, one try, two try, sell it back down. Another scenario to keep in mind is the trading range, right? We stay lower, but we don't keep going lower. We go sideways, one try, two try, back down again. We're selling that second try. And then, of course, the third scenario, which I would almost expect at this point now, would be that lower low. Once you get that lower low, you draw that trend line, copy and paste it up. Now that tells you sell off the high. And then again, as we get lower here and we get closer to that objective down at 52 and a quarter, we start looking for traps. Trap pattern right off that high. Remember, anytime you're running short of space, in other words, as we keep going lower here, we get closer to that 52 and a quarter area, we start shifting our focus from pullbacks, right, to traps, right? How do you know when to look for a trap and when to look for a pullback? Well, let's just say, for example, we have that big move down, right? We bounce. That creates a low. We then get this short covering rally, right? Then we collapse back down again. We know where those sellers are looking for. We know they want to get back down to that low. So I can look for pullback patterns until I get close, right? I can look for pullbacks here. I can look for pullbacks there. But once I start getting down close to that low now, what's going to happen? Nobody's going to want to sell down here. So the best way to do it now at this point now is to look for not pullbacks, but look for traps, right? Find those prior swings and look for traps from there. Does that make sense? Right? You're trying to find a way to sell as high as you can because we're running low on space. So look for pullback patterns when you got plenty of space, but shift your focus from pullbacks, right, to trap patterns once you start running low on available space. And how do you know when you're running low? You always have to know where's the market's objective, right? Where's the market's objective? The market's objective is always going to be either a channel retest, a range retest, or a higher low retest. And we'll talk more about that in our trade room tomorrow and go over, right, more about market objectives. But you've got to know who has control, where the objective is, and that will tell you when you're running low on space. Once you're running low on space, you shift your focus from selling pullbacks or buying pullbacks to buy or selling with traps, because traps will allow you to get in at a much better price. It's usually the only pattern you can rely on as you go lower. Now, I would be remiss if I didn't talk about a possible reversal. In all reality, this whole move came off of earnings. So we could be in store for a reversal, right? We had that big bull day today. It wasn't until the very end this thing collapsed here, going back down. Now, it is way too bearish right now to call trying to call a bottom on this. So what would a reversal look like? A reversal is pretty simple. It's going to require what we call the 1-2-3 reversal. Actually, I'm sorry, the 1-2-3 reversal, right? That exclamation at the end. I'm sorry, I didn't put the emphasis where I normally do. So what I'm looking for here is I want to see that one strong move higher get above the moving average, 2, pull back to the moving average, and 3, reversal. Real, real strong. Want to see a good example of one? Right there. That is a 1, 2, 3 reversal. Right? See it? Not this one, not that one. That's a 1, 2, bam, reversal. Those are buyers bailing on this market. That's what causes a reversal. It's not just a strong move up. We've got a strong move up. We've got to pull back to that moving average. And then, bam, see that nice strong move off. The exact opposite of what happened here. Strong pullback. This would normally be a buying opportunity with that 2-try. The 2-try didn't fail, though. It succeeded, and that reverses that trend. So we're looking for those selling opportunities as we go higher. But as always, we're going to keep an eye out for those reversals. And now you know when to shift your focus from pullbacks right to traps. Let's keep going. How about some Nasdaq? Now, the Nasdaq is almost a carbon copy here tonight of the S&P. Nasdaq is bearish with a strong spike lower, got a hidden channel and a measured move on the chart tonight. The strong spike lower tells me that sellers have the control, but I need to wait for a retracement off of these lows up into levels of resistance before I can start putting together right some sells here tomorrow. Now, again, the big thing right now is we got that big move down, right? Big move down yesterday. We saw mostly bullish today. Earnings come out, and then blammo, this thing launches lower. That momentum is way too strong to be called a pullback in the bull market. This is a bear market, whether we like it or not. Now, where's the objective? Where are the sellers trying to go? They're trying to go back down and retest that low. Now that we know the objective, now we know when we're going to get too low to sell. Once you know the objective, then you can start to plan, right, the best entries. So, now that we got that under our belts, now let's find some levels of resistance. Strong move down, I want to sell high and take my money out right at the low of that range. What can we do here with this? There's not much to work with, right? It's a straight line down. So really at this point, I'm making my best effort to see what we can use for tomorrow. I'm going to draw lines off that low up to that high. That looks like it fits pretty well. Right? The midline looks like it fits pretty well. So much like the S&P, not much to work with, but I'll tell you, one of these opportunities here, we'd love to get this thing, get back above the moving average, 1-try, 2-try, back down into that pullback pattern, right? 1-try, 2-try, 2-try failure, right? Into that hidden channel pullback. Okay, that will be wonderful. We can use those levels of resistance. And then of course, we got that one leg, two leg, right, for that big runner. But again, make no mistake, 86 is where those sellers are trying to go. Now, again, as I mentioned earlier, we may also see either a range or this thing may turn into a channel. So we got strong move down. If we start seeing double bottoms or a triangle starting to form here, right, we know the drill. With that range now, we now look for what? We want to sell above the range using that 2-try failure pattern. 1-try, 2-try, back down in. Now, guys, again, these 2-try failure patterns come in lots of different shapes and sizes. Sometimes they'll go like this, 1-2, and then back down. Sometimes opposite, 1-2, and back down. Sometimes they're very large, and sometimes they're rather small. If you want a really deeper dive into these entry patterns, just grab that free course. It's upper right-hand corner in the information icon, the upper right-hand corner, and it's also linked up in the description of the YouTube video and below the video on the blog tonight. So we're looking for that 1-try, 2-try. 1-try, 2-try, right? That will be the proper pattern, 1-try, 2-try failure for a trading range. What if we keep going lower? Right? What if we make that lower low now? Bingo. Once we make that lower low, find that new channel, that becomes a spiking channel. I'm selling off the high of that channel. But then as we go lower, what's the problem now? Watch out. We're running right into that low. So now what do? We focus on traps. How do you know when to look for traps? Anytime you're really pressed with not a lot of space to go. Then we start looking for traps and we start looking to get up above those highs where buyers will get trapped and we can sell it back down again. very, very similar to what we just talked about on the S&P. And just like the S&P, could this market reverse? Absolutely it could. You know, we spent most of today going higher. So this could easily try to retest this high here, but how do we feel comfortable buying it? Strength, a move against the moving average, a strong move against the trend gets above the moving average, then what? We pull back to the moving average and we blast off, right? We find that blast off, okay? That's what we call the 1-2-3 reversal. Once we have the reversal, then what do? Once it jumps off that high, then what? Then we mark up that high, that becomes support. We mark up that high, that's the high of the channel. We find a new hidden channel and we're buying that pullback for the objective going back up to retest that high. Okay, now remember, just because we see a strong move up doesn't mean we're going to reverse. Look for that one try, two try, and sell it back down. Okay, that'll be the most reliable thing to do until we turn bullish. You can see lots of examples on this Nasdaq today. We go up, one try, two try, back up. We go up, one try, two try, back up. I'm telling you, this two-try failure pattern is gold if you're going with the trend, you know where your objective is. And again, we'll talk all about those ideas inside that free trading class if you want to learn more. Let's keep going. How about some gold here tonight? Gold definitely has plenty to talk about tonight. As you can see, lots going on the gold. We're making up for analysis we're missing on the S&P and the Nasdaq. Gold is bullish with a trading range, a triangle, and a measured move on the chart this evening. The bulls have the short-term edge coming off the low of this range, but in the big picture, we can see the overall momentum is neutral. So the plan is to buy the low, sell the high, avoid the middle, and focus on those two try failures. And the most important thing right now on gold, we got that big move up. That gives the bulls an edge. We get a big move down. That gives the bears. I think this thing is pretty neutral right now. I've got rising support. I've got falling resistance. Now, what does a triangle tell me to do? What does a triangle tell me? Triangles tell me to watch the edges. Watch the edges, right? Watch the anchors of that triangle. So we're definitely watching this, we're watching that, we're watching these edges. So for example, the edge up top here, up and try to sell back down from there, right? If we go up, we come down, find the edges up, right down, and then back up from there. We want to focus on those edges. That's where you're going to find the most reliable turning points on a triangle. What else does a triangle tell us? Triangle also tells us that as these two trend lines come together, we start running low on space. Now, we talked about briefly on the E-minis, we run low on space. What happens? Traps. On a triangle, when we run low on space, we typically see a big breakout in one direction. Almost impossible to tell what direction that will be in, but what you want to look for is one of two scenarios. Let's say we get stuck in the middle of this triangle tomorrow and we break the downside. Now, at this point now, you don't want to sell that. You want to look for that two try failure and back up in. One try down, second try off the moving average. We're buying right into those stops as we go back up into that range. Or maybe, right, maybe we go the opposite direction. Maybe we're in the middle, right? Maybe we go up, maybe we jump up, nice big jump. Do not buy that. Can't buy that. It's a range bound market. Look back here. Right? You want to buy that breakout? Go ahead. Not with my account though. Right? Yeah, do not buy those breakouts. You can see those big breakouts aren't going to make you very much money. You're more likely now to wait for that to pull back, try again off the moving average. If I can draw this here. Right? Try again off the moving average and sell this thing going back in. Now, what would a breakout look like if it's strong enough and it could hold? And we get that 1-2-3 breakout, same thing as a 1-2-3 reversal, 1-2-3, if we can hold that pullback, which none of them have been able to do yet, right? Lots of potential breakouts, but if they can hold that breakout, what do? Mark up that high, find the new channel, you got it, and we're buying, right, that pullback. That's your sweet spot from there. So that's what the triangle tells us, right? Triangle tells us focus on the edges, fade those moves, right? Up, back, down, down, back, up. And what pattern do we use? One try, two try, failure. One try, two try, failure, right? One try, two try, failure. This one didn't give you much to work with. One try, two try, failure. Once you see that second try, then you know once it fails, right, you're in going in the opposite direction. Now, another big clue here is this trading range. The trading range, I think, is the foundation of this move. Take this trading range, the size of that range, copy and paste it down. That creates support at 29.6. Copy and paste it up. That creates resistance around 39.6. So those levels as well, big levels of resistance overhead, big levels of support below. So if I can combine these range expansion levels at 29.6 and 39.6 along with those patterns, right? One try, two try, back up. One try, two try, back down. We're going to be on a roll tomorrow morning. The hardest part about a range, though, is going to be staying away from that middle. Staying away from that middle. And lately, it's been a little bit sluggish on gold, so be very careful trying to force trades in the middle. When things get sloppy in the middle of a range, you're better off waiting for that breakout, right? And then buying that two try once it goes, right? Once it tries to break out that second time. Better off sitting on your hands, right, than trying to force trades when they're inside of that trading range. So get out of that range, buy low, sell high, use that two try failure pattern, and watch out for those breakouts once that triangle, right, comes to a head. Let's keep going. Wrapping up here tonight on the euro. Euro is bearish with a trading range, channel, and measured move on the chart this evening. The bears definitely have the momentum. That's pretty easy to see, right? The bears are in control right now. So the goal in that situation is to sell at resistance levels. But with this trading range, and we talked about this range last night, right? With this trading range, more importantly, the way we can take the range and find the range expansion, look where we stalled out. I mean, is that a coincidence? Now, you could say it's 14,000. Okay, I would agree with you on that. But I'll tell you, the way that this market ran lower and just stopped right at that range expansion. Remember, that range, take that range, create resistance, take that range, create support, and look what we stalled out at. That's pretty crazy. So what we have is the range. We went up, one try, two try, failure. That's that two try failure pattern I keep talking about, right? Strong move down. There's that double bottom. That double bottom last night told us that's a range. When we have the range, what do? One try, two try, back down in. So you can see what we're talking about tonight on a lot of these range patterns. That's exactly what happened today on the euro. Now, strong move down. Can I buy this? That's the big question, right? I'm going to tell you guys the same thing I tell my clients. When a market is bearish and we're below the low of this range, I do not want to sell down here. Because we know that there's likelihood until we can get through this range expansion level, until we can really push through 14,000, you've almost got to look at this and go, trading range, pendulum swings up, pendulum swings down, we're going to swing back up again. And that's honestly what I'm looking for. I don't really have any way to justify being a seller right now. If this would have just gone a little bit through that range expansion, I would be able to kind of latch on to something more. But the fact that it didn't, the fact that it's using that range expansion as clear support right now tells me, I'm thinking we go back to 15,000. I'm thinking we're back up here around 14.8 tomorrow morning. So we're bearish though. Here's the problem. How do we buy this thing? Because you don't want to go one try, two try, back up. Because what will happen a lot of times is there'll be sellers up here waiting here to trap you out. And look, there's a trend line right there too. So if you like to take a little bit of risk, if you like a little bit of danger every once in a while, feel free to look for that trap high pattern to sell off of the high of that channel. It's just tough though because, again, you've got that range expansion level right there. It's very attractive, but it's just, again, like I said, with that range and that range expansion, I just don't trust it. I just don't trust it. And this is one of those times where I might be wrong on this, but I'd rather be really confident, right, than to try to take a trade that I'm not really so sure about. So I'm looking at this as a range expansion support level. How do we buy this? We buy it by using the two try, what I call the nested two try. So we have this run lower here. As we go back, what I'm watching for is a very specific pattern. I'm looking for one try lower. Go back up. I'm looking for two tries lower. And here's the dream come true. The dream come true pattern is a trap low, right? I call this a nested two try with trap combination. What this does is this embraces the momentum going lower. Okay, remember the momentum is bearish right now. And anytime you have a strong move in one direction, you know those bears are going to want to bury this thing down to that measured move. Okay, if I don't trust that, I can wait for them to try once, go to a higher high, try twice, and this is where the magic happens, that little trap low. Okay, and in my trade room, we also call this a crown reversal pattern, right? Down, higher low, lower low, reversal. It kind of looks like a little crown, right? A little crown like you know, have the top of your head. Or maybe not on my head, maybe on your head, right? The bottom line, though, is that we get a couple different names for it, though, right? It's a two-try trap long. If we can get a nice signal candle off it, closing above that trend line, that's going to be a great buy here tomorrow morning, and that's a pattern I'm going to be watching closely. Another opportunity here would be, let's just say that we jump. Right? We jump back up. That kind of gives it away. The market's bullish now. Let's get that moving average coming over. Let's find that new channel. And let's try our best to buy as close to that low as we can. That's going to be the trick here. Because again, we don't want to buy into the high of that range here. So we want to get this price pulling back, right, and going. Maybe a trap low, maybe a two-try failure, right? But again, trying to buy off of that, right off of that low. So those are two patterns I'm watching for tomorrow for the buy side. For the sell side, what would it look like? Well, probably a spike in channel. If we keep on rolling lower, then we're going to know where the deal is, right? If we keep rolling lower here, but the problem is going to be by the time we have enough proof that these bears really want this, we're going to be knocking on the door of that objective, the measured move. And what do we always talk about? Whenever we're running low on space, we look for what? We look for traps. Mark up those prior swings, look for that trap, and sell that trap high. That way you're freeing up enough space to do some serious damage on the way down to getting that measured move. Sellers will not want to sell into support. They're going to wait to get at a higher price to free up some profit and make it worth their time. And that's exactly what we're looking for there tomorrow. So guys, I know I kind of cruised through this tonight, not normally my lengthy video tonight, but I hope you guys learned a lot, got a great plan for tomorrow. Once again, I apologize, I'm a little bit late here on the video tonight, but don't forget, I'll make it up to you guys tomorrow morning in our trade room. We open up every morning with all of our advanced members at 8 o'clock Eastern time. We have a great trade room, a great strategy, and by the way, if you want to learn more, a great free trial. I got a free pass inside of that free trial to come test drive the trade room. Call me anytime if you have any questions. I got toll-free phone numbers, email, Skype, and we also have live support if you need help along the way. Tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock Eastern time, we're going to do it together. If we don't see you guys tomorrow morning, we don't do the newsletter on Friday afternoons. Next newsletter is next Monday. Have a great weekend. If we don't see you guys tomorrow morning, be here next time. My name is Joseph. Be well out there. Be nice to each other, will ya? Adios, amigos. Bye-bye for now.